Hi everyone, today I'm going to make a video about a recent find. I got this today and I was really surprised when I got this. This is a Ricoh 500G. It's a rangefinder camera. It came with a strap which looks like this. And I am absolutely impressed with the quality of the lens strap. Usually when you go to thrift stores, you get the tattered and battered and smelly strap. So I got the camera and the strap. I also got a Sunpak MX144 hot shoe flash. I don't think it came with a battery, but I think you can insert two AA's right there. But I won't discuss about it that much. But here's what it looks like with I've seen this Ricoh 500G before on eBay listings. However, I wasn't really interested in purchasing them because the price, it's a little bit steep for me for a camera like this. So, but I did do my research on the internet. This was actually produced in 1972 by Taiwan Ricoh company. This is a 35mm camera and with a Ricoh lens for 40mm. As far as the shutter goes or the aperture, it comes with 2.8 up to f16, and then the shutter goes up to 500. It says here B. I'm not really sure if the bulb mode works, but I guess it's safe to say that it goes from 8 to 500, and then you have a bulb right there. I don't know if you could see it. I'll take pictures, and then maybe I'll do the blog first, the blog entry first, before I post the video so that you guys can see. It's been compared to the other compact rangefinder, and yes, this is a rangefinder. I think it's a coupled rangefinder, and for comparison's sake, this is what the Ricoh GR 500G, and this is what my Konica C35 automatic look like. So when you put them side by side, so it actually looks like this, and I'm not really sure if it's the color, but I think the Konica lens is more compact than the Ricoh one. But the thing is, this one, it's automatic aperture with this one. I mean, you just need to set the ISO and focus it, and the rest, like the camera does it for you. With this one, it's actually more manual because you need to set your own you need to set your aperture before you, and then you set the shutter speed. It says that you have an automatic for the aperture. I'm not really sure how will that work, but anyway, aside from that, the not the shutter speed, the film speed goes up to 800 ISO. So that's the highest that it could take. And like the C35, you change your ISO by pressing the two sides right here, and then you turn this around. You can see the dial right here, and then it changes. Okay. Okay. Believe the lowest ISO is 25. Okay, and again, for comparison's sake, I pulled out. This is my Canon at 28. So this is what they look like. So the Canon 28 is a bit taller, and the lens is a lot bigger. Although they both run for 40mm lens, as you can see. So, So things that I like so far is, I mean, I like the how compact it is, and for some reason, like, I know for some people chrome cameras don't appeal too much. I've heard one person that I've met before said that black cameras, like especially black film cameras, are really sexy, but for this one I think the chrome one has more appeal, if you ask me. I also like how solid this feels. I mean, this one is feels about the same, but this one is a lot lighter than this one. I'm not sure if it has something to do with the lens or is it just the belt. But aside from that, like the general characteristic of this particular camera, it feels like it's battered, and I'm not even sure if it was really used up really well. There's like a lot of scratches. Oops, my tripod is falling. Like there's like a lot of scratches right here, and another thing is like the lens. Can you see this? It moves. I don't think it's supposed to move because this one is like intact, but this one, it moves, and I feel like it needs some serious repair. And aside from that, the I don't know if this one had a filter before, but you can see right here it has some serious scratches, like this one as well. I think I might have to bring it to the repair shop. The viewfinder though, I find it really small. Something that I don't like with this camera, like the viewfinder is really small. Like if I were to use a rangefinder for some really serious street photography, I would just use my Canon 28, or even better, I will use my QL17, because the viewfinder is a lot easier to manage, and it's a lot easier to see the image so that you can merge them together, so that's easier for you to focus. At the moment, I can't, maybe because this is like a new camera, that's why I'm having a hard time using it yet. And also this part right here that opens the back cover, it feels like it's gonna fall out. I don't know, it really needs some serious repair, so I might have to bring it to the to a camera repair shop when I find the time after work. When you look inside, the light seals are really bad. Like it's really sticky, as you can see. Like if I touch it, like the foam falls in. When you touch it, like the foam's really soft now and it's sticky, and it's like your thumb marks like making a soft dent there, and the light seals are like marking right here and they're sticking. I might have to like have the whole thing cleaned because I think it will work well, but I have to wait and see how this one will work. So yeah, I read a website, which I will include on the description box, that this camera does have really ugly light seals. So as you can see, like this is how it looks like when the light seals haven't been replaced. As far as the shutter sounds, I think it needs battery for it to meter, but so anyway, there's a cell timer too. I'm not sure if it works, but it doesn't. I haven't checked the battery yet, but very good. So this is what it sounds like. I've heard that it makes a different sound, but it doesn't look like it. Maybe because it doesn't have a battery. So that's what it looks like. I am really hoping that I'll be able to have this repaired. I'm really worried about the lens, to be perfectly honest. But I mean, for $6, battered camera, I mean, what can you expect? But I've heard so many things about this camera. I've heard that the Ricoh lens cannot compare to, like, the Hexanon one. I think the Hexanon one is a lot sharper, based from the articles that I've read. But I've seen photos of the Ricoh lens, and it's actually good. I mean, both of them are 2.8, if I'm not, like, the C35 was 2.8 lens, and but I'm not really sure who to believe in regards to the quality of the glass. So yeah, this is basically the Ricoh 500G. I will be posting photos on my blog so that you can see it closely, and I hope you guys like this video, and I hope to talk to you soon. Bye.